Hello, my name is Kendra Winchester. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to be doing a Book Expo unboxing because I mailed all of the books back to my house. So you probably saw in your social media feed that Book Expo and BookCon were last week. So Book Expo is the professional trade show side of the convention that goes for 3 days. And then the last 2 days are BookCon, which is for readers and fans like Dylan. Yes, Dylan. Ugh. Dylan is a reader and a fan. I brought him back a lot of books. He's very excited. Are you very excited for all of these books? Are you more excited to play in the box? If it fits, I sits. Is that right, Dylan? Okay. Anyway, so it was really lovely. I've never been to Book Expo before. And so Autumn and I went to Book Expo, the business side, because we had a reading woman, and we were able to meet Robert from Barter Hordes, Russell Ink and Paper Blog, Matthew Schrappa, and Jen at Insert Literary Pun Here. We had a great time. Autumn, our honorary booktuber for the week. And it was great. It was great to see people and talk to publicists who I'd only emailed up to this point, and I just had a really great time. I live in a small town, and so having an entire convention of people equally as obsessed with books as I am is just absolutely fabulous. So I'm going to cut to the unboxing, so I hope you enjoy. Dylan, are you gonna help me? Are you gonna help me unbox books? You excited? It's not snack time. No, it's books time. He's not convinced. Hello, yes, welcome down here. We are going to be opening this box, but first I want to show you some books that I stuffed in my suitcase, and then we will go in through here. I'm not gonna say much about the book. I'm just gonna say the title and the author, and we'll go from there. So three books that I bought. We went to the Lit Bar, and this is How the Garcia Girls Lost Their Accents by Julia Alvarez. This is a reissue from Algonquin Paperbacks. And I picked this one because, one, the Peter Reads recommended the reissues of this author's novels, but also because this was in the Bronx section of the bookstore. So I thought it was very fitting to pick up a Bronx story at the Lit Bar. Great new bookstore. I will link it down below. We also went to The Strand, and predictably, I bought Virginia Woolf, Women in Writing. This is one of the matching hardcore editions. I also picked up an out-of-print copy of the hardback of Zadie Smith's Changing My Mind. This is an essay collection, and apparently I am now collecting all of her print hardback books now. I don't know why, but here we are. Okay, so at Book Expo, they do what's called ARC drops, and so they'll be like, you want American Dirt, it's dropping tomorrow at 2 p.m. Come back tomorrow and see if you can grab a copy, and then all mayhem ensues. So I was late to an ARC drop, and I almost missed this one. This is Pages & Co. Book Wanderers. This is by our very own Anna James. She is also a booktuber and does a lot of different bookish things, and this is out from Philomel, and I grabbed one of the last copies. I am so happy that I did. Matthew Schrappa picked up this one for me, and this is Midsummer Mayhem by Rajani LaRocca. It's out from Yellow Jacket, and it's signed. It's a finished copy, and I'm just like one of the very few finished copies I picked up at Book Expo. And I met the author, and she was lovely, and she handed me this little box of handmade chocolates. It had rose and cardamom chocolate. Oh, lovely person, just lovely person. I also picked up Jacqueline Woodson's Red at the Bone. It's out from Riverhead. And yes, Jacqueline Woodson. I mean, I don't even need to tell you what this book is about. I don't even know what it's about. It doesn't matter. It's Jacqueline Woodson. So we were at this panel with Glory Edom, and they were giving away copies of her book. So I was able to get this one signed. So the other copy I already own, we're going to do a giveaway over on Reading Women at some point. But we met her, and Russell and I basically fangirled all over the place, and we got pictures taken with her, and I don't know where theirs are. I should probably check. One of my most anticipated books from Book Expo is Hollow Kingdom by Kira Jane Buxton. It's out from Grand Central. And this is about a crow named, we'll just say Crap Turd, but his initials are ST. So ST narrates this post-apocalyptic novel. There's also some sort of dog, and I don't know why the dog is narrating. I don't care. It's amazing. I mean, just look at that. The moment that Autumn and I heard about this book, we were like, yes. And so this is one of the few books that we each got a copy of because we were both obsessed. and she also signed them, so why not? I also picked up a copy of this. This is Inland. This is from the author of The Tiger's Wife, and everyone is talking about it, and I can't believe I picked up a copy of it. The end. Like, I also met Eweki Yamezi. They are wonderful. This is their first YA book, Pet, and I think this is one of the only YA books I picked up at the entire Book Expo event, and of course it's because I loved Freshwater, and that makes sense. Also, it's so pretty. One of the only finished copies I picked up at Book Expo is Ask Again Yes by Mary Beth Keane. She signed this, and it was lovely. I got to meet her, and I already have the audio, and I am so behind in all of my audiobook listening, but yes, just look at that cover. This is out from Scribner. All right, the time has arrived. Let's open up this box. All right. This is the bottom of the box, apparently. I don't even know how to open boxes. Ordinary Girls, a memoir by Jakira Diaz, and this is out from Algonquin. Whose Story Is This? Old Conflicts, New Chapters, Rebecca Solnit. This is an essay collection out from Haymarket. Trinity Site by Jennifer Javon, and this is out from Blackstone. She signed it as well, so so cool. This is a book out from Scribe, which is an Australian publisher, I believe, that has a office in the United States now. And this is Who Killed Maria Drames? And this is inside the number one true crime podcast, set by Rachel Brown. This is definitely one of Autumn's picks, because if you remember, she's obsessed with true crime. So, yeah. I mean, it has pretty much Autumn, like, written all over it. Out from William Morrow is My Dark Vanessa by Kate Elizabeth Russell. I think this is one of the buzz picks. I don't know. I missed that panel, but we got a bunch of the books, so go forth. Okay, so this one I have to tell a little story. So this is Attica Locke's Heaven, My Home. You know I'm obsessed with Attica Locke. And so I didn't realize, you know, I walked in the door of Book Expo with no idea what's going on. And so then I see Matthew Sharapa, and he says, "Oh, Kendra, you love Attica Locke. Here, have this." And he gave it to me, and I compulsively hugged him because it is Attica Locke. So thank you, Matthew. I appreciate it. Also, this is out from Little Brown. So this is out from Norton, and this is actually based on a book that I really want to read, which is Smoke Gets in Your Eyes. And this one is Will My Cat Eat My Eyeballs? Big Questions from Tiny Mortals About Death. And so the author, I believe, works in a funeral home or as an embalmer, or she works at a crematorium. I'm not sure. And that was what her first book was about. And this book just seems so funny, and I needed it. Autumn is also very interested, so it checked both of our boxes for sure. The next book is a very much talked about book, and that is Such a Fun Age by Kylie Reed. It's out from Putnam, and it is just gorgeous. So this one is out from I believe it's a Canadian publisher, I'm not sure. It was over in the Canadian section of publishers over there. And it was All the Better Part of Me by Molly Ringel. And this is out from Central Avenue. And I believe this is about a bisexual woman, which makes sense considering the colors on the cover. Many of you love Liz Moore, and like I do, and this is Long Bright River, and this is her new book, and it's coming out from Riverhead Books. It comes out in 2020. I did not even realize this was a 2020 title until I looked on the spine. So, I think that's my second 2020 title of this year. I feel so behind already. And next up is Life Undercover, Coming of Age in the CIA by Amaryllis Fox. This is out from Knopf. This is a book about food, so Autumn and I both squealed and grabbed for a copy. And this is Midway, Burn the Place, a memoir by Ileana Reagan. This is from MCD Books, and Autumn picked this one up. This is Uncanny Valley, a memoir by Anna Weiner, and this comes out in January. So this one Russell picked up for me. This is Hachette, and this is The Third Rainbow Girl, The Long Life of a Double Murder in Appalachia by Emma Copley Eisenberg. There we go. This is a mystery set in Appalachia, and this comes out in January as well. And whenever I see a book set in Appalachia, I get very excited, but then hold my breath and hope that it works out, because so far all the novels I've read about Appalachia this year are just not cutting it. So I have good high hopes for this one. This one is from One World, and this is How to Be an Anti-Racist by Ibram X. Kendi. This is one of the few books by a guy I picked up because I really loved Sam from the Beginning, which won the National Book Award, and this is his next book. This is another YA book that I picked up. It's out from Philomel, and this is The Fountains of Silence by Ruta Sepetys, and this is from the author that wrote Between Shades of Grey. So this is one of the few copies that we picked up, each picked up a copy, and this is Leslie Jameson's new essay collection, Make It Scream, Make It Burn, and this is out from Little Brown in September. Autumn really loves Leslie Jameson's book, The Recovering, and I really enjoy Leslie Jameson's writing style, but you know, like, she and I have a very one-sided, tumultuous relationship for different reasons, but I know very few people who can write better prose than Leslie Jameson, and we met her, and she's lovely, and so I am willing to give her another shot, because she is a very, very, very talented writer, just ridiculously talented. So this is a young adult or a middle reader, I'm not sure. This is Renee Watson, Some Places More Than Others. This was a very buzzy title this year at Book Expo, and this is How We Fight for Our Lives, a memoir by Saeed Jones. And this is out from Simon & Schuster. Next is a book that I'm interested to see other reviews on. It comes out in August. This is Litza Lutz's The Swallows. And I don't know. I've seen mixed reviews on this so far, so I'll be interested to see how the reviews come out in the future and what people are saying about it. Next is a book that I think Autumn picked up, because I don't remember picking this up. This is That's Mental, Painfully Funny Things That Drive Me Crazy About Being Mentally Ill by Amanda Rosenberg. We are doing a theme on mental health and physical health later in the year. So I think she may have picked this up for that. And this comes out in November from, wait for it, Turner Publishing. Oh, Turner Publishing. Yes. Okay. Now I remember. This is a indie press in Nashville, Tennessee, I want to say, and we discovered them as one of like the first publishers we walked by, and when you come across a Southern indie publisher, we are always just like, yes, just yes. Another book from Turner is Kim Hooper's Tiny, and this comes out June 11th, very soon, probably already out. One of the buzziest titles at Book Expo this year was American Dirt by Janine Cummings, and this is out from Flatiron Books, and it's coming out in January of 2020. So another 2020 title. One of the books that Autumn and I are most excited for is this copy of The Shadow King by Maza Mengiste, and this is out from Norton, and we immediately saw it the first day, wrote down when the drop was, and we swarmed there and were able to get a signed copy before they ran out, and oh, they're so beautiful. I have another book from Scribe here, and it was on the shortlist for the Stella Prize. This is The Bridge by Enza Gandolfo. This is a book from Simon & Schuster called The Dearly Beloved by Carol Wall. This is The Other's Gold by Elizabeth Ames, and this is out from Viking. This is Jeanette Winterson's new novel, Frankenstein, I think is how you would say that, but I saw Jeanette Winterson and freaked out. This is from Grove Atlantic. This is Mighty Justice, My Life in Civil Rights by Devi Johnson Roundtree and Katie McCabe, with the foreword by Terry Jones, and this is out from Algonquin. This is The Gracier by Kim Leggett, and is out from Wednesday Books. This one is also out from Scribe, and this is Invented Lives by Andrea Goldsmith. From the Dial Press is Dear Edward by Anne Neapolitano. This is another book from Scribe. This is Hope Farm by Peggy Frew. Okay, we're getting to the end of the box now. So from Little A Publishing is A Well-Read Woman, The Life, Loves, and Legacy of Ruth Rappaport. And this is about, I believe, a librarian of some kind. But I saw Well-Read Woman and was like, yes, yes, please. Can I have a copy of that? Another book from Little A is Man Fast by Natasha Scripture. Epic last name there. This is about giving up men and having, I think she has a breakup and then she goes off men for a while. This one is Three Women by Lisa Tadeo. This is from Avid Reader Press, and this was a pretty buzzy title. The line for this was so long, and then I saw one like floating around and grabbed it. Or maybe someone else grabbed this for me. Maybe Russell grabbed this for me. I don't know. I don't know how I got this book. Why is it in this box? I just saw it a lot and it's magically here. I don't know. I feel like this is like the big red couch of book boxes. A book that Autumn picked up is Loaded, A Disarming History of the Second Amendment by Roxanne Dunbar Ortiz. And this is out from City Lights Press. I also picked up a lot of comics. Some of the highlights are The Avant-Gardes, Volume 1, The Lumberjanes, The Infernal Compass, love The Lumberjanes. This is The Magician's Alice's Story, and Little Witches, which is pretty cute. So now that my library looks kind of intense, those are the books that I picked up at Book Expo. I will link all of them down below with their release dates, publishers, anything, other information that you could so desire will be linked down below. So definitely go check those out. But yeah, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.